him a sign, as you can see there. This sort of tells us exactly where we're going, what we're doing, how long. So that first day, we've got about 5 hours journey, going up, what, about 3,000 metres, so best part of 3 Snowdons, I reckon. So that's day one. We'll report as we go through, as soon as we get. Another 4 days, we're up there. That's day one. So we've made it up to camp. We've done 2,835 meters in elevation, which is fantastic. Legs a little tired, altitude's fine at the moment. There's the famous sign. We come across, hopefully. You can see Killy just up there, so we've got to get up that side. But fantastic first day. Okay, so it's day two. Today we're gonna go 800 meters upwards. So 800 meters, but it's gonna take us about 6 hours. And that's because it's really, 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 really steep. So quite dangerous today. They've asked us to pack really light. View. So we've got one set of clouds, as you can see, and then higher up you get, you hit another band of clouds as well. It's just that's day two done. As you can see, we've reached the Shiva Cave camp. We're about 3,750 meters. So pretty high, actually, highest I've ever been. So day three, we are starting the climb from 3,750 to 4,600. Once we get to 4,600 and we've had lunch, we then descend actually to 3,900, where we're then going to stay overnight. Again, we go up high, get the acclimatization, sleep low, so that then tomorrow when we start to scramble, we're kind of used to the altitude. Last night sleeping for everybody in camp wasn't great. I felt I didn't sleep very well, very on off, on off. But that's what it is. We live another day. Today. Close to me. Watch the world come alive tonight. Stay close to me. Tonight, this could be the greatest night of our lives. Let's make a new start.
The future is ours to find. Can you see it? Can you see?
So we've made it to Lava Tower. You can see the sign just over here. We are currently at 4,600 meters. That was a tough climb, I'll be honest with you. We've done, 5.5 miles in about 4 hours, but going up to 4,600 with the altitude really, really does get you. We're gonna stay here now and trying to acclimatise. Because we got to get up that beast. Okay, we got to get up that one. So start of day 4, slept really, really, really well actually. Actually had a paracetamol just before I went to bed. Read a little bit of my book, slowed my heart rate down. And actually I think I probably got about 6 hours on and off, which is brilliant. So today is going to be another tough day. Same as yesterday, really big long walks. They reckon it's going to be about 8 hours worth of walking, and I don't think you can see it, but we're going to tackle this wall that's behind us, what we call the wall. And if I zoom in, we've got to tackle this wall here. I don't know if you can just see those people right in the middle. We've got to climb, or scramble should I say, up that. We're going to get all the way to the top, which at the moment is covered in clouds. So it's quite a dangerous little trek here, actually. 45. Watch the world come alive tonight. Stay close to me. Oh, and the world comes alive. And the world. Just arrived into base camp. You can see the famous sign here. Hard day. Barranca wall at the beginning was brilliant, as Mr. Pillin said. Real tough climb, but afterwards, this has been tough. But made it to base camp. Tomorrow, we climb that bugger. Can't wait. Woo! Day 5, summit morning. It's 11:30. I reckon I got about an hour and a half. Most people probably got about the same. So we're gonna head off in about 30 minutes to try and reach that summit. As you can tell by the video, it's pitch black. It's freezing. We're just trying to get some ginger tea in us. Hopefully the next time you'll see me, we'll be at the summit. So wish us luck. Absolute slog and a half. That was the hardest thing I think I've ever done in my life. We started with 9, we finished with 5. Such is the summit day. Absolutely knackering. I'm exhausted. Got up at 11. We've made it here at 8:30 in the morning. So we've been walking for 8 hours constantly uphill, trying to get to the front of this this mountain. But I'm so proud of myself that we've done it. Look at those views. Absolutely spectacular. Can you see him?
Well, after 9 hours, setting off at midnight in the dark, and one of the hardest days of my life. We are at the roof of Africa, and I feel absolutely dreadful. What a day. Whoever said this was easy, well, you can't have done it.
Day six, obviously yesterday was summit day. You saw the video at the very top, but what I didn't do at the was that once we got down to base camp from the top of Kilimanjaro, we then had another 3-hour walk to get down to lower altitude. So yesterday I think managed to smash 45,000 steps, which was an absolute killer really. So we're just absolutely shattered, had a bit of food and went straight to sleep. So day six, so what we're doing now is we are going from 3,000, which was the lower camp, go all the way down to the bottom and exiting through the gates to the actual mountain. So hopefully the next little video will be us. So we will have gone from the bottom of the mountain all the way to the top, and then from the top of the mountain all the way down to the bottom. So this is just a nice leisurely 3-hour walk this morning. Loosen up the legs, go and enjoy going through the rainforest right at the bottom, so the microclimate, so we'll get a little bit warmer. So here's the last day.
Listen to your dad, this is our motto. Your time to shine, don't wait in line, y vamos por todo. People are raising their expectations. Yeah. Don't wanna feed them, this is your moment, no hesitation. Woo!
Better now. What a 6 days that's been.
Can you highlight any highlights, mate?
Highlights was summit night, the most physically and mentally challenging thing I have ever done. Starting at midnight, walking through the night, feeling delirious, feeling like I could fall asleep like that. In fact, I probably did. But it was worth it in the end, and we've done it with some great people, some of which, including you, Mr. Mystery, are old friends from Silcoats. And it just goes to show that Silcoats isn't just, whilst you're there, it's something from your life that you'll always have friends from those years that you'll go on and do things like this. So, yeah. Live.
Africa, jungle.